hundreds of millions of Americans know.
Why do our elected officials put us at such risk?
We can't survive $20 trillion
of outstanding public
debt. We must balance the budget now.
It's going bankrupt if it's not bankrupt already.
If we don't fix it now, some of the wisest people we saw knew that it would change forever.
Hey, if you're out there and you're listening, you're exactly 65, I've got some news for you. You're going to take out of the system Medicare, Medicaid, Social Security, the entitlement programs. You're going to take out $327,000 more than you put in. And if you're a baby and you're zero and you can't understand this, parents, listen. They're going to be forced to pay $400,000 plus more over the course of their lifetime than they're ever going to get out. This problem, this intergenerational transfer of wealth, is something we've never seen. We've always had a situation where we want to leave the country better for our children, and yet we're not. And it's both parties. The Republican Party doesn't want anybody over the age of 53 to pay for any of the changes that are coming in Social Security. Why? 53 is the baby boomers and on up. It's wrong. It's immoral. The older people in this country can't call themselves the greatest generation, leaving the young people on the hook. And the young people need to rise up and get angry about this. If you're in college, you got to listen. You got to go call your parents and your grandpa and say, Dad, Grandpa, this can't go on any longer. We got to get our act together. We've got to balance not just the national deficit of over $17 trillion. We got to balance this $220 trillion. That's 220. Write it down. With 12 more zeros. Look at it. The country's going broke. The country is broke over this. So we need a new Social Security program. We got to fix that $33 trillion problem in the next year or two, where young people get their own program. And they move on. And when they get to be a certain age, we stop buying annuities for them. And it's theirs. And the people who are already on it, we've got to find a way to make people retire a little bit later. People are living a lot longer. And no more conversations like I'm entitled to it. That's not America. The conversation is, what can we do for our kids? That's what has to happen in America, has to happen now, and this message has to be delivered to everybody before this whole thing spins out of control, where rates move higher and we have to cut back on everything like you've never seen.